Thank you very much for joining us. You'll see that this week we're doing a little bit of fishing, and my able assistant Tina has been out fishing earlier, and she's brought you just brought what you have in the bath. No, go and get me a proper fish, and then I'll tell you a story about a proper fish. I can't work under these circumstances. Not now. I'll have the gospel reading first. We'll listen to our gospel reading.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told the chief priests and leaders to listen to this story. A landowner once planted a vineyard. He built a wall around it, dug a pit and crushed the grapes in. He also built a lookout tower. Then he rented out his vineyard and left the country. When it was harvest time, the owner sent some of his servants to get the share of the grapes. But the renters grabbed these servants, they beat them up, killed one and stoned the other to death. He then sent more servants than he did the first time, but the renters treated them in the same way. Finally, the owner sent his son to the renters because he thought that they would respect him. But when they saw the man's son, they said, "Someday he will own the vineyard. Let's kill him. Then we can have it for ourselves." So they grabbed him, threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. Jesus asked, "When the owner of the vineyard comes, what do you suppose he will do to the renters?" The chief priests and leaders answered, "He will kill them in some horrible way. Then he will rent out his vineyard to people who will give him his share of the grapes at harvest time." Jesus replied, "Surely you know what the scriptures say. The stone that the builders tossed aside is the most important stone of all. This is something amazing that the Lord has done. I tell you that God's kingdom will be taken from you and given to the people who do what it demands."
So this week, you're thinking about CAFOD and the way we share the resources that we have with those around us and those further afield, remembering that it's all God's world. And there's a very famous saying, which is, "Give a man a fish and he'll eat for the day. Teach a man to fish," what?
I've got you your fish.
Where did you catch that?
Asda. £2 for £4.
Give a man a fish and he'll eat for the day. Teach a man to fish and he'll eat for the rest of his life. In other words, share all the gifts and talents that we have. Unlike those in the gospel, they didn't share what they had. Here, take this then.
Thanks.
Oh, look at this. You wrapped it nicely, didn't you?
Yeah.
So, it reminded me of the story of the rainbow fish. Ugh, that's a live one. This is a rainbow trout, it's the nearest we can get. Say hello.
Hello.
Once upon a time, there was a beautiful, beautiful rainbow fish. And its scales were, it's very slimy. Its scales were lots of beautiful different colours. And it glided round the sea. It glided round. And it said, "Look at me, how beautiful I am, how beautiful I am." And the little blue fish swam by and said, "Oh, rainbow fish, you are beautiful. Please, could I have one of your shiny scales?" And the rainbow fish said, "No, you can't have one of my shiny scales, because then I won't be as beautiful." And the little blue fish said, "Oh, please, rainbow fish." "No, you can't." And he swam away. But sadly, the rainbow fish was lonely. Oh, he'd nobody to play with because he wouldn't share. And so he decided he would go and see the wise octopus. Can you come here and be the wise octopus? He came to see the wise octopus. And the wise octopus said, "Oh, rainbow fish, the problem is you won't share. If you share your beautiful scales," because the octopus said it a bit like me, "oh, if you share those scales, you'll be happy." So the rainbow fish swam away, And when the little blue fish came up again, said, "Here, you can have one of my scales." And the little blue fish was delighted and swam with glee and glee and glee and went and told his friends. And all his friends came and said, "Please, can we have one of your shiny scales?" And the rainbow fish said, "Well, okay, you can." And in the end, the rainbow fish looked more like this. But he was happy because he'd shared everything that he had and swam around with all his new friends. Basically, we have a choice. We can either be like the rainbow fish at the beginning, selfish, unhappy and proud, or we can share what we have with those around and further afield, remembering it all comes from God. And if we do that, then we'll be truly happy. And CAFOD is a great way for us to share what we have with those around and further afield. So, we're going to remember that now as we pray for everybody together. Yeah. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hey, Tina, what's this one doing? La, 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 la. Practice of his scales. Ha, ha. I think that wasn't bad, really. I think we'll keep that one.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see,